an all-time high of 18,332. That's how many new COVID-19 cases the Philippines reported Monday. This raises the number of active infections to 130,350, the highest since April 19th. 151 people also succumbed to the disease. The grim figures come as the Philippine Genome Center confirmed the detection of 466 more carriers of the highly contagious Delta COVID-19 variant, majority of which are local cases. Nearly half of them live in Metro Manila, while dozens of others are in Central Luzon, Western Visayas, and Calabozon. A health official believes community transmission of the Delta variant may have already been observed in two regions.
But definitely, I can tell all of you, Region 4A and NCR, na we have seen and observed, no, especially in NCR and Region 4A, na talagang mukhang community transmission na ito, nakita natin na wala nang link ang mga kaso sa bawat isa. There, lahat ng action natin ay geared towards that level of community transmission already.
ABS-CBN Data Analytics Head Edson Guido projects total COVID cases in the country will reach 2 million by early September.
The ongoing spike in COVID-19 cases this August has already exceeded the previous peak in April this year. Data from the Health Department show the number of average daily reported cases in the Philippines was at around 14,300 from August 16 to 22. That's higher than the average of 10,400 cases reported from March 29 to April 4.
Reverse, no? From the Mindanao and Visayas contributing what we will do, no? And what we have been doing.
Meanwhile, the capacity and intensive care units across hospitals in Metro Manila is now under high-risk classification. Health Undersecretary Leopoldo Vega says one of the nearly 1,300 ICU beds in the National Capital Region, 73% are currently occupied.
State insurer PhilHealth defends its temporary suspension of payments to healthcare providers with allegedly questionable claims. That's despite the threat of some hospital groups to disengage from PhilHealth due to its unpaid debts. Hospitals say patients will now be forced to shoulder hospital expenses in full, but PhilHealth maintains suspension of claims is an old policy.
Temporary suspension of claims has been there since 2016. In the last 2 years, we implemented this for around 26 providers. Some of them were healthcare professionals. So we just don't arbitrarily implement stoppage of these claims. We're talking with the hospitals. We will not let that reach to that extent wherein they disengage.
The House Committee on Health will hold a hearing later today to discuss the issue between PhilHealth and private hospitals.
Roughly 70% of active COVID-19 cases in the National Capital Region are unvaccinated individuals. Metropolitan Manila Development Authority Chairman Benher Abalos says the unvaccinated make up more than 15,000 of the 21,000 active infections in NCR.
70%. Look at the death. Look at the critical and look at the severe. These data will speak for themselves that really it's very important to get vaccinated.
Meanwhile, Abalos says 78% of senior citizens in NCR have already been fully vaccinated. 41% of individuals with comorbidities have also received their second dose.
Several Metro Manila cities have opened their COVID-19 vaccination drives to non-residents. These cities include San Juan, Pateros, Mandaluyong, and Marikina, which are nearly done vaccinating its residents. Those from nearby provinces of Cavite, Laguna, Bulacan, and Rizal can register online to schedule the vaccination.
Kami sa Mandaluyong, halos 90% na ho kami, nagmamapping up na lang kami. Pateros, tapos na rin po. Nag-usap kami, pati San Juan is tapos na rin po. Inopen na po namin sa mga hindi tiga lugar namin. Inopen na namin, hindi lamang tiga NCR, pati sa neighbors namin.
Over 13 million Filipinos have so far been fully inoculated against COVID-19. That's about 18.5% of the government's target by the end of the year.
Another single-dose COVID vaccine gets emergency use authorization in the Philippines. The Russian-made Sputnik Lite is the 9th COVID jab approved by the Philippine Food and Drug Administration. Sputnik Lite has been shown to have 79.4% efficacy compared to 91.6% for the two-shot Sputnik V.
We will follow up yung ano yung more or less 10 million natin ano na doses. It will become tiyatawag natin 10 million treatments, meaning 10 million na tao ang makikinabang nito ng full protection, considering that yung Sputnik Lite is one dose na siya.
The FDA's authorization for Sputnik Lite comes 4 months after it granted an EUA to the single-dose vaccine of Johnson & Johnson.